Welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to discuss uniform spherical shell of charge. Means electric field intensity. We have to find electric field intensity due to uniform spherical shell of charge. So let me introduce first of all a spherical shell. So a spherical shell of a charge is a spherical distribution of charge in which the charge is distributed on the surface alone. The interior does not have any charge on it. So let's consider this one is a spherical shell on which charge Q plus Q is uniformly distributed, and we have to find electric field intensity at different places. There may be three possible cases. First, electric field intensity due to this arrangement may be found just outside or at the surface or inside this spherical shell. Okay. So let's consider first case. Electric field outside. Case number one. Electric field outside a uniform spherical shell of charge. So first case of a spherical shell of radius r, charge on its sphere is uniformly distributed plus q, and point of observation should be lie in first case outside. So let's consider we have to find electric field at this point P, which is r distance away from this center. And we have taken here positive charge. So due to this positive charge, electric field intensity will be radially outward. So let's consider, we have to draw a Gaussian surface. So this one is a Gaussian surface of radius r, and let's consider a small area element, and direction of this area element will be always perpendicular to the surface, and due to this positive charge, electric field at point P will be radially outward. So if we calculate how much electric flux will pass through this area element, so electric flux is given by phi is equal to surface integral of electric field over a closed surface. And just look at this diagram. Here angle between these two vector, area element vector and electric field, both acting in a same direction, so theta will be 0, and this phi can be written as dot product of two value, E magnitude, ds magnitude, and angle between these two, which is cos 0, and cos 0 is equal to 1. So phi is equal to close integral E ds. E, which is electric field produced by this arrangement, which is a constant. So phi is equal to, we may take just outside of this operator, so E close integral of ds. So ds is area element. If we add all these area element of this Gaussian surface, so we will get ds, surface integral of this ds is equal to 4 pi आर स्क्वायर. सो इट विल बी इक्वल टू फाइ इज इक्वल टू ई इंटू फोर पाई आर स्क्वायर. इक्वेशन नंबर वन. इफ यू अप्लाई गॉस लॉ according to Gauss law, phi is equal to 1 upon epsilon naught times total charge enclosed in that Gaussian surface. So how much charge enclosed in this Gaussian surface which we have considered here? Only q. So it will be equal to q. Equation number 2. So if we compare this equation number 2 and equation number 1, both are same. So now comparing these two equation from equation 1 and 2. So E into 4 pi R square is equal to 1 upon epsilon naught times Q. So E will be equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. So electric field due to this arrangement outside a uniform spherical shell of charge is found to be this one, E is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. So this equation shows that uniform spherical shell of charge behaves like a point charge located at its center for point in its interior. Now second case, if this P point, which is an observation point, if lies exactly at the surface of this spherical shell, case number 2, at surface of spherical shell, so electric field intensity due to this arrangement at the surface of a spherical shell means this point P should lies exactly at the surface. So there will be only one change. This r, small r, will be exactly equal to r. This implies that in this case this r will be equal to r. And in this case, what is the relation between these two? Here this small r is much greater than r, but in this case r is exactly equal to r. So electric field at surface is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r, capital R square. Now third case, if we calculate electric field of this arrangement inside this Gaussian surface at any point. In first case we have taken that point of observation just outside. In second case we have taken that point at the surface, and in next case that point, observation point, should lies inside the spherical shell. So third case, case number 3, electric field in the interior of a uniform spherical shell of charge just look at this diagram. Now for case third, that point P should lies inside this spherical shell. So let's consider we have to find electric field at this point. So just draw a Gaussian surface of radius small r. So if we calculate electric flux passing through this one, so electric flux passing through Gaussian surface, Gaussian surface. Okay, so in this third case, this small r is less than capital R surface. So electric flux will be equal to electric flux is equal to E into surface area of that Gaussian surface, and surface area of this Gaussian surface will be equal to 4 pi r square. So E into 4 pi r square, equation number 1. And using Gauss law, electric flux is equal to 1 upon epsilon naught times total charge enclosed in that Gaussian surface. Now look at this diagram. Total charge enclosed in that Gaussian surface. So in this Gaussian surface there is no any charge, because charge is lies on the surface of a spherical shell, and we are calculating electric field inside the spherical shell. So here electric flux will be equal to phi is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times total charge, and total charge enclosed in that Gaussian surface will be 0. So something upon 0 will be 0. Equation number 2. Now compare this equation number 1 and equation number 2, both are same. So comparing these two equations from equation first and second, E into 4 pi r square is equal to 0. So if you calculate electric field, it will be equal to 0. Means electric field inside a uniform spherical shell of charge will be 0.